Do you want to talk?
Not right now, man.
Because I heard you talking about Alex Jones from 2004. I'm a huge Alex Jones fan as well.
I gotta wait for the cocaine to kick in. I gotta wait for the shrooms to kick in.
Allegedly, hypothetically.
There's Scotty, Cactus Scotty.
We know what you're up to, Netflix.
We'll
the truth is out. We already know.
Hey, what's going on, brother?
What's up?
Can you tell everybody what Pizzagate is?
You know what? I don't want to jump into the conspiracy. I want to talk about the facts. That's all I want to talk about.
That would
it's
be
statistics.
Awesome.
It's statistics. Numbers. That's the only reason that I'm doing this is numbers.
So you're, Scotty, you're leading this. You're organizing this event, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool. So do you want to tell us what's going on here?
Sure. So there's an extremely huge problem with human trafficking. There are several pieces of this puzzle. The implementation of pedophilia through media indoctrination through education of our children and the laws being lowered, the offense being lowered for somebody who has had sexual engagement with a child in our state is being lowered. It's making it easier for offenders.
What's the age of consent?
The age of is 18.
It's 18, right? But in California, you're saying it's being lowered?
No, it's not the age of consent that's being lowered. So there was a law, SB 145, that was just passed. If you have sex with a child outside of the 10-year mark, then you have to register as a sex offender. But for some people, it's a misdemeanor or they don't have to register. So a 26-year-old can have sex with a 17-year-old, but since it's 9 years, he doesn't have to register. And it goes all the way down. That's how they gauge it. Right.
I think those are called Romeo and Juliet laws or something, right?
Possibly. I mean,
but,
honestly, I don't
really.
Don't
they have it? Don't they have that in, like, I don't know, in like places like in red states? The age of consent is already even lower than that, to 16, isn't it?
Right. Some of that needs to change.
So you want to increase the age of consent in?
I just don't see why 18 can't be the age of consent across the board.
Hey, I agree.
In general, I'm not. You know, I'm just saying that's. I'm very passionate about that idea. The brain is not fully developed until people are 21 years old. But you know, like that's if we want to get down to it.
I'm 29. My brain is still not fully developed.
100%. Exactly. 100%. So essentially, there's just so. The numbers are astronomical. And the fact that it's not the main basis of every conversation of the problem of our generation is just blows my mind, which is why it's like this is a campaign about awareness. If you are aware, you can avoid your. If you're aware, it creates prevention. You can prevent it. You can see the signs.
So you're saying you're trying to make people aware that, like, there's people out there that want to have sex with kids.
That want to have sex with kids. That want to snatch your kids more than you know, more than you think, and they're getting less scared and they're being more blunt. If pedophiles could have it the way they want, they're trying to tie this into a sexual orientation.
So I have a question.
Sure.
How does Netflix find its way into, like, how does Netflix become a willing party?
Netflix just got an indictment on Tuesday for child porn for their film Cuties. It displayed a child acting in a sexual manner with a visualization of a crotch. That is child pornography. That is not appropriate. So a senator from Texas.
So do you think Netflix is silently giving their endorsement to pedophilia?
So essentially, I think that this is a plan. There's a whole entire scheme and plan
to disseminate it.
To normalize pedophilia. It's going to start with LGBTQP. Pedophilia is a sexual orientation. No, it's not.
Wait, isn't that 4chan, though? Look, we're nerds, okay?
No, totally.
We're indoors all the time, so we frequent these blogs.
I'm just saying, I'm not even going off of blogs. I'm going off of people that have sent me hundreds of pages of people that are actually claiming these things and laws.
Yeah, but aren't they trolling? Like, those are, like, literal 4chan.
Trolling or not, they need to be shut down because of what happens.
I agree. We should shut down 4chan.
What happens? What happens when a kid stumbles upon that page? Right? A kid shouldn't even really be on social media like that. But these people, that's their demographic is children. So they're putting a film out like that just makes 11-year-old females think that they are sexually empowered.
So my question.
Do you think 11-year-old females are going to watch the Cuties on Netflix?
I think younger children, it's called Netflix. Parents have doing a horrible job on what their kids are watching. Why is pedophilia such a problem? them because their parents aren't paying attention to who they're talking to on the internet. There's a whole issue with that. There's a problem. It's a new word. Our generation is the first generation to have to deal with this problem because the internet didn't exist 25 years ago. It doesn't move like it does now. We know that.
So why do you think Netflix involves themselves in this? Like, what motivates them to disseminate?
I think that it's all the same people. When you go, I'm from Hollywood. When you go up the chain and you get to know more and more people, rich or famous, one or the either or both, they all know each other. So that's it doesn't mean that they're all pedophiles because they know some people know what other people are doing but are too scared because they know that person holds power, that person holds weight in this industry. In this industry, you can look how easy cancel culture is. All we need to do is put out fake articles about somebody doing something bad. Overnight, everybody believes it and hates them. It's that easy. What happens if a super famous celebrity, I have a super famous 60 million person follower celebrity that's one of my best friends is her best friend. She says, I would love to come, but I can't. So why can't you? I can't, because I'm so big that my career will be over. Find a way to cancel.
But aren't they complicit if they're also part of the Hollywood pedophile cabal?
I'm not talking about a cabal. I'm talking about Netflix actually putting out a film. That's the proof right there. I'm not talking about a conspiracy cabal. I'm talking about a film that's available right now to watch 11-year-old girls busting their legs open.
So I'm not saying I agree with it, but no. The counter argument right now.
Sure.
Did you watch it? Wait, hold on. Did you watch the...
No, I don't... Not. I understand that it was...
Wait, do you know what it's... What's
yes, I do, but that's like you molesting a boy and saying, oh, there's a problem with pedophilia.
No, I didn't watch it. I thought it was gross.
I'm not saying you watched it. I'm saying that the idea behind it was see how they sexually exploit our children? It was an example of the exploitation of children in media and in the industry. So you're showing me a little 11-year-old girl's vagina lips through her shorts to prove to me that the industry is trying
Wait,
to fight.
So you did watch
it's like somebody. No, I saw
yeah,
the. I saw.
The clips,
yeah.
How do you see the vagina lips?
No, because I put out the trailer, and that's all you needed. The trailer had it.
The trailer had it?
The trailer had it, dude. The trailer had it. So I'm not going to, that's like somebody molesting a boy to be like, oh, see, pedophile is a problem. Pedophilia is a problem. So you're going to have 11-year-old girls audition. Who knows what they're wearing or not wearing? Oh, you know what? I can't really see her body because she's going to be in a bikini in a shot. Can we put her in a bikini? You're going to tell me that didn't happen behind closed doors? Not saying they got molested or raped, but that happened.
So again, what I was getting at is a lot of people who are standing kind of in line with this film, their argument is that it's culture. It's a French movie. What do you say to that?
I don't care a French movie, an African movie. If you're displaying a child in a sexual way on camera, there's nothing okay with that. You can push the you can push the envelope as much as you want. You know that you have grown men, pedophiles, sitting at home jacking off, looking at an 11-year-old girl.
What do you think about child beauty pageants?
Child beauty pageants? Honestly, I can't really say as far as just because. There is I'm a performer, right? I'm a musician, so I love performing. I was a performer. I performed in my talent show when I was 10 years old. I'm a performer. These little girls, in a sense, there is an art and fun performance to it.
Wait,
should
really?
You take that? I mean, the don't dancing and stuff like that, I don't...
Don't you think that they're sexualizing children in beauty pageants?
I do. Too much, but at the same time, my cousin, being a beauty pageant queen, was never in it to be sexually exploited.
Wait, your cousin was in a beauty pageant?
One of my cousins, she's now 30. She was in beauty pageants when I was a kid growing up, and I remember, and she enjoyed dancing, singing, talent, being rewarded for her talent. Now, my aunt and uncle definitely were there every step of the way to make sure nothing happened to her. Our parents there like that all the time?
Do you think the kids, the parents of the kids that signed a consent form for like the kids being depicted in the movie Cuties were there every step of the way with them?
It's hard to say. I can't say yes or no because I don't know the facts behind that.
Wait, don't you think that the same logic would apply? I think they're both gross. Right. I'll be honest with you. I think child beauty pageants, they're gross and they should be banned.
Give me one.
And I wholeheartedly disavow. I think it's terrible. But I also think Cuties is terrible for similar reasons. You mentioned that, for example, people could potentially get off on watching cuties.
Right.
Don't you think that people could potentially get off on watching child beauty pageants as well?
Yeah, they could, but if you're putting it on Netflix, which is a mainstream media outlet, it's, come on, what is the default for watching Netflix and chill? What's the default for media?
Did you guys protest like Lifetime and stuff too, because they were doing that?
No, maybe we should, because if they're doing it too, they're part of the same problem. We're combating that whole problem, and that's where the awareness comes in. That's where we need to recognize what's happening always. And parents need to do a better job at monitoring what their kids are watching. Your kid, whatever, the information is food to the soul. So what are you feeding your child?
Okay, so if you were to talk to the kids that were in the Cuties movie, depicted in gross sexual ways, and they were to say, well, I'm an artist, I'm an actor, and, you know, I don't have any problem with it, and my parents were there every step of the way, would you change your stance on it?
No, because at the same time, I'm going to ask that mom, are you comfortable with 1,000 men jerking off to your daughter? Because that's the reality. There's that many pedophiles out here who are, it's that big of an issue. Like, I'm telling you, pedophile, it goes hand in hand with human trafficking.
But would you say the same about your cousin being in a beauty pageant then, and their parents?
Like, I think the distinction he's drawing is, Netflix didn't distribute the beauty pageant.
Right, right. And the thing is like, yeah, a man could go onto YouTube and look that up. A man could go and see my cousin's video footage, and the same thing could happen. But is it being put in advertisements in our face? Netflix, the biggest media outlet source of film right now, is that they're the top dog. So that's what I'm saying. They're the top dog. They're the default.
Oh, shit. Dude, why are you turning me towards it?
No, I was trying to turn.
It's fine. Also, don't freak out about it. It's like, if it's in the background unintentionally, it's fine. There's, sorry. We got rigorous.
No, you're good.
I thought this was going to be a good Christian gathering. There's male butts everywhere.
Yeah, there's everybody, yeah. Because it's like...
Do you think that guy with the male butt on his sign is maybe a...
Male butt?
He's like a male booty up there. You see that?
And across his
on that sign.
This one right here? This
more,
one. Yeah. You know what? Everybody has a right to their voice. So there's not... You know, somebody wants to... This is America. That's the beauty. You can go outside.
But you don't like seeing that, do you?
No,
I don't.
I'm not a big fan. I don't even.
This is a short film, bro.
Okay.
He actually made this film to raise
awareness. Okay.
All right. And sometimes shock value works. I understand how you could get confused. Nothing against your film at all.
Wait, if shock value works, isn't that literally how Netflix thought Cuties would be
depicted? Right. And I'm not saying that that's necessarily.
This actually is an education to make you aware. You get out your 15-year-old.
Wait, that's literally the argument that Cuties
true,
make.
True. Right.
Like where they're
yeah,
saying.
Yeah, but that's a grown man. That's a grown man, not an 11-year-old girl. There's
okay,
a big
it's
difference.
It's still gross, though.
Yeah, it's still gross, but it's still a grown man.
Okay.
Right.
I agree.
So that's the difference.
Sexualizing children.
I don't think you're. There
should be a fucking argument about
this.
Yeah.
No,
there isn't an argument. There's a conversation.
I agree.
He's
I don't
argument.
Disagree with
He's conversing.
You. That's why I'm also anti-beauty pageants. Anti-beauty pageants.
Anti-child
beauty.
I know.
No, I know, but the cause is trying to stop children from being abducted, right?
Exactly.
Yes.
It all feeds into itself.
Anyway, so let's talk more about QAnon.
I'm not part of QAnon.
You're not part of QAnon. I heard that there's no. Okay. Not QAnon, but websites on the internet like 8chan and 4chan that are doing drops about.
I don't have 8chan. I don't have 4chan. And I on my family's life, I honestly mean that I don't use any of those sites.
Okay. Well, I mean. Because I've heard that Q is no longer able to use the terminology Q because the federal agents are onto it and that they're investigating it or something.
Yeah, and they.
I think freedom of speech all the way.
Sure, and they have the right to investigate, and they're gonna find what they find, and if somebody has something to hide, then it's gonna come to light, and if they don't, then nothing's there to find. So
yeah.
They can look into all of us if they want. They're gonna find nothing because we're doing nothing but the right thing and standing up for people who can't speak.
Well, yeah, I know you got to talk to a ton of people. Is there anyone else here?
What up, brother?
This dude,
you are a lot taller in real life. That's Andrew with All Gas No Breaks. You guys, hey, what's going on, guys?
Yeah. How did I do with the signature?
Hold on,
signature.
You look fantastic.
Thanks, bro.
It's good. We're out here interviewing some people right now. What's up, guys? It's good. Wait, do they live with you?
Yeah.
Oh, damn. Oh, these are the two homies.
This is a team.
Cool. This is a team.
I can get her to say I'm blowing the chauffeur because they can't pronounce the horn.
Let's all gather together right here. We're going to cover the front area of Netflix. Stay on the sidewalk. We are not allowed to step into this property right here. It is not public property.
That was, that's the main guy, Scotty,
the
kid.
Do not step onto the grounds over here. But yeah. I need all of you guys to line up down the
He's a rapper.
Right in front of Netflix.
He's a white rapper.
It's going to be a drone shot. And we're going to rap.
What? Yeah, I'm going to ask him.
Thank you guys for being here. Let's get going. I'm going to have you guys.
Yeah. Signature. Go over there. Let me get it.
Follow me this way.
Oh, shit.
Excuse me. All right. You guys can come down here.
I want to get both of you guys in the same with the same suit. Wait, this is not the eBay one. This is a new one, right? Look at that. Where's the condom, dude? That shit's not secure right now.
We don't have it anymore.
Anyway, these guys they mean business. They're pro. They're, from what I've gathered so far, they're pro beauty pageant, but they're anti Netflix.
This is about cuties, right?
I think he was very pointed not to talk about QAnon. I think you'd do better talking to somebody.
Awesome. Nice.
What's up?
Do you want
to? Got a good one on the Facebook.
Oh.
Do you want to give us some info on what's going on here today?
Sure.
Oh, hell yeah. Love that. Okay, first of all, I love your hat. Trump, no more bullshit.
Thank you. Okay. I forgot my hat, so my daughter has this one. So
what's going on with this crystal quartz thing?
This is from Brazil. I got it from a lady at a park in Point Fermin when they have the bands coming. But we're here today in protest of Netflix and the cuties, in protest of what's going on with all the children, and the children are being taught to have sexual encounters at like 7 years of age, and they're wanting to continue in this, and it's really a bad thing, and our government, the Democrats, are supporting all of it and making laws and rules to protect themselves when this should be atrociously pedophiles and selling children should be a jail sentence.
Do you? I agree. Do you think that? Have you been a lifelong Republican?
No.
Oh, so you were a Democrat?
No.
What were you?
I just like to follow what God says and save the defenseless, which are the orphans and the children, and to make the people aware of this and what's actually going on. These children have no voice. They're muted with their mouths. They're taken into vans. They're
because of the mask?
They don't want them to know what's going on. They don't want them to know that Pizzagate exists, and they order hot dogs, and they're doing atrocities.
So for the layman,
what's Pizzagate? Pizzagate, to what I understand, are places where you can actually go purchase children. Oh. And they call them pizza and hot dogs, and there's certain titles. Yeah, if you don't want onions, or if you're gay and you want another boy because you're a man, and they have different things of how
so
you
different
order.
Menu items.
Do you know what they
and
are?
They
what the menu items
send
are?
Send them out like a pizza box.
How do you mean?
I haven't actually witnessed it, but they put the children in a box and send them to the people.
They put them in a box?
Like a pizza.
How do they survive the box?
I don't know if they put air holes or what. I'm just hearing about this stuff, and it's just
where have you heard about this stuff?
On the internet and doing the research and coming to be a part of these things like this.
Like Facebook or what are they?
Oh, Facebook. It's all over the place now because of people like us that are willing to step out and protect the children because they don't have a voice for them.
Are you voting for Donald Trump?
Yes, sir.
But did you vote for Donald Trump last time? Ooh.
I didn't vote for a few years because I've been injured. I couldn't get up to do it. But I was very wanting Trump to come in to help us repair America and keep it, because the Democrats want to destroy it and get us into a new world order, which actually means a different deity other than God.
What do you think about the children that the Obama administration abducted under their immigration removal program?
I think it's not fair, and I think that Trump should be filing charges on all of them, and that everybody needs to see Obama do it.
You think Trump should be filing charges the previous administration kidnapping children.
Oh, not only that, but they're treason against the American people.
And locking them up, too, right? Like, they separated these kids from their parents. Like,
yes.
Obama, he had a child abduction facility in Oklahoma under the INS. Okay, and the DHS, this is how they used it. I mean, anyone who would do that is terrible, right?
Yes, I don't want to see this go on, so we're here protesting to make others aware of it. A vote for Biden is a vote saying, yeah, we want all these laws to hurt children.
Now, why do you think that?
Wait, hold on. I have one more question. Sorry. So I've done some research on this as well, and I've heard that the Trump administration has also... under ICE, under the Immigration and Customs Enforcement, their immigrant removal operations have separated kids from the border at their families. Do you know why they're doing that?
A child in the U.S.
They're trying to get them to go back to their own countries. If they want to come in, there's a process. You need to go through Ellis Island. You need to learn English. You need to learn the ways, the Constitution, and how we're supposed to all get along and be in unity, which is why we're called the United States of America.
So you think it's different than what Obama did?
Yes, Obama was brought in to destroy America and to bring it under Muslim control. And I told them that before Obama got in, and they didn't listen.
Barack Hussein Obama. Barack Hussein Obama.
Actually, Barry and Michael, and they killed all kinds of people, and they weren't even up front to let us know that Michael was
Strike extrajudiciously American citizens.
Exactly.
Right?
It's treasonous.
Isn't it crazy that Trump did also the same, though? Like, Donald Trump did the exact same thing where there was a guy that Barack Obama killed, an American citizen, and then Donald Trump also signed off on the same executive order that killed that person's sister. So two American citizens were killed by drone strikes, one under Obama and one under Donald Trump.
I wasn't aware of the Trump. I'll have to research.
Yeah.
I do not like them doing this to the children. I do not like sexual innuendos for 7 years old on television, Netflix. You know, it's not right. You don't start a child to have sexual encounters at the age of 8. Messes with their mind, and then they keep wanting to have the sexual relations.
Yeah.
And it's
like, if a president was talking about how his daughter, you know how Barack Obama had two daughters, like, if a president was talking about how his daughters are hot or attractive, or I'm sorry for using unchristian like language here, but if they made it seem like they wanted to fuck their daughter, that would be gross, right?
That God doesn't like it for purposes of...
No, I agree.
It's supposed to procreate.
Yeah. No, I agree.
I appreciate you guys coming and finding out.
Thanks for talking to us.
Yeah, thank you.
We appreciate you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You guys have a good day.
You
too. Thank you so much.
What's up? What were you saying?
That was perfect.
Yeah. Just let me do my thing. I know what I'm doing. Boy, you're doing great. Thank you. Let's go talk to some other people.
Can I just ask, what is the horn?
The horn is a conch shell.
Sure.
It comes from the ocean.
Sure.
I learned about this. I have a guru from India.
Okay.
So he taught me about the conch shell, really, what it does. That sound is dispelling darkness, not only in this surroundings, but the universe.
Sure. So
that's the lore behind it.
So we're blowing that to blow the...
Dispel darkness.
Got it.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Hell yeah.
Shock the system.
What are you wearing? It says free as fuck?
Free as fuck.
It's a little bit of curse. I mean, this is a Christian stream, but
free
hey.
Free as F.
Yeah, free as F. Free as
F. You and the sea have been blocked
yeah.
out.
A little bit of profanity. It's all right. Sometimes we gotta have. Sometimes we gotta have fun, but...
It's just... It's a vibe.
It's a vibe. I agree.
Because I think we have to stand up for that.
So, if you don't mind me asking, you're wearing some Grunt Force. Did you vote for Donald Trump?
I don't vote.
You don't vote? Hell yeah. Why don't
you? It's time to draw the line. It's time to draw the line.
I don't trust the system. I mean, I had hoped that he would be different because he was allegedly outside the norm, but I don't know if I trust any of them, to be honest. If you break down politics, what is politics? Poly is multiple, and ticks are bloodsuckers. So what are you really getting?
Bloodsuckers. Multiple
bloodsuckers.
Yeah.
I've never thought of the etymology of that word.
What I've kind of come to the conclusion is that I'm working on myself, working on creating positive, loving vibe in my house, teaching them the truth, teaching them discipline.
think COVID is a hoax?
No, it's not a hoax. It's a real virus. But the mask thing and all that stuff, this is intentional. It's designed to suppress your voice. Because if you know what a virus is an excretion. It's an exosome. It's smaller than the grids in your mask. So why are they making us do this?
Don't you think that... So they were... Doctors wear surgical masks, right?
They do.
And isn't that kind of the same thing?
It is a somewhat of a preventative measure. If you'll realize in March, Fauci said masks are useless on healthy people. I believe it's all a show. I also believe that it's intentional to tell you that you don't have a voice.
Fauci also...
If you research history, even before Islam, in the Middle East, they used masks to take away individuality, so you fit more into a herd mindset.
Is that why they wear hijabs, the women?
That eventually was the result of that. It was before that. Yeah, absolutely. Even slavery in this country, the slave masters had their slaves wear masks as a symbol.
But don't nuns wear stuff too? Like, don't
I guess
all
you could say that. I guess you could say that.
Isn't that the same energy?
You know, I hadn't thought about it. For me personally, the way I feel, if I even think about putting on a mask, I can't do it. Because I just, COVID's not a hoax. COVID is real. People are getting sick from it. It was manufactured in a lab.
It was manufactured.
You can see the whole money trail to China, Wuhan.
Where does that money start?
Well, it was started from the Obama administration with Dr. Fauci. They were in cahoots. For the vaccine. I mean, it's all business.
You think Fauci worked with Obama?
They did. Okay. There's documents that I've seen.
Why would Donald Trump keep him on, though? Or is Donald Trump...
You know, and I don't know. I'll be honest. I don't try... I had faith that maybe some stuff would change.
Sure.
But I just think it's lip service at this point. I don't know if we ever get true, real change from the system. I don't know if the system will ever change.
Multiple blood suckers.
I mean, too many people are getting too enriched from this whole thing. This whole COVID thing. Who got rich?
It was the billionaires.
Billionaires.
Right? Agreed.
And 60% of Yelp businesses disappeared.
I also agree.
Which is you and I. Which is like, so what are they going to do? Are they just waiting for a government handout? I mean, who's going to feed them? That's just starting. So I don't trust any of them, to be honest.
So you don't want a government handout, but you also think that the government is mishandling the COVID crisis.
Well, they mishandle everything.
I agree with that.
The government mishandles everything.
Yeah.
And the solution is never more government. I'm more, I guess you could say I'm libertarian leaning. I want this to be a republic, and I want everybody's voice to be able to be heard.
And be free as that.
Are you familiar with...
Exactly.
Oh, okay, but you're not like a libertarian, because Rothbard, famous libertarian, once directly advocated for parents having the right to be able to sell their children as property.
Yeah, see, there's, again, I hate to be put into a category. Everybody,
and a lot of libertarians also hate the age of consent law.
And it's... Yeah, I want no part of that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Me
it's
either.
I don't want to be labeled. I just want to be left alone by the government. I'm willing to pay my fair share, but none of the money's ever used.
For ongoing wars, always, right?
It's been endless wars. That one thing I will say about Trump, we at least don't have new wars under him. They may be secretive. At least they didn't start new wars. If you'll look back at videos from 2003, General Wesley Clark talked about this. He said, we're going to invade all these countries back in 2003.
I'm friends with his son.
Are you really? So
yeah.
You're well aware of that.
Then. Yeah, I am aware of Wesley Clark. I mean, he's a little bit more of a lefty, but, I don't like that. But what are you going
to
do?
At least he was able to speak the truth about that, to say these wars are all planned.
So,
and if you want to dig deeper, it's a bankster thing.
So Donald Trump is not starting any new wars, but he's still continuing the old ones. I don't like that.
You know, same thing, same
deficits. What do you think about Iran? Like, he executed a leader, the second-in-command in Iran. And then COVID happened, so they were functionally powerless to do anything, which I guess is a blessing. But don't you think that that's an incitement?
I think it's all an incitement. It's all designed to get our attention and get us distracted from our own lives. It's such a show right now and such a circus. I literally the last 2 months, I can't watch it.
Yeah.
And you gotta understand, guys, I grew up a sports guy. I grew up a Padre fan. Love my Padres, love my Chargers. I follow neither. The Padres, they just had a playoff series. I didn't watch a second. And I grew up, like, everything was baseball.
Yeah.
And I hate that they're using that stage as political theater for agendas that I don't agree with. I mean,
Black Lives Matter, yes. Black Lives, but Black Lives Matter is a communist organization. White Lives Matter. Asian lives, everybody's lives.
Wait, what do you?
Animals' lives matter.
Black Lives Matter is a communist organization?
If you research the history on that.
Really?
Yeah, the CEO, they're communist. They're trained
the CEO?
Marxists. They're trained Marxists, yeah.
It's, okay.
Well, I'll tell you this.
Wait, do you
just
do
on
you
your
have...
phone, just type in antifa.com on your phone browser.
Uh-huh.
It will take you to Joe Biden's website.
No way. Wait, but isn't it free to just buy a domain and then revert it to anything?
I researched that, no. But how ironic would it be that antifa.com goes directly to Joe Biden?
Yeah, but it's out of their power, I think, right?
That is a possibility.
Especially if he's like denouncing.
I just find it an ironic coincidence.
Oh, okay, got it. As far as Marxism goes, so you said Black Lives Matter leader is a trained Marxist or
they've been schooled in Marxist philosophies. Do you think
there's something wrong with that?
I don't agree with Marxism, to be honest with you.
I don't
agree with crony capitalism either. So, you know, there's
What is your problem with Marxism?
I just don't like taking from the productive to give to the people that don't want to work.
I agree. I think that the productive, the workers,
and you disincentivize people to actually step outside of themselves and overcome their insecurities and inadequacies.
So you worked like retail ever or any of those sorts of jobs?
Did I do retail? You know what? I worked, when I was young, I worked at SeaWorld.
Yeah, so when you worked at SeaWorld, oh, God.
SeaWorld.
Oh, God. I won't hold that against you.
I wore one of those Gumby jumpsuits, and I learned how to park cars.
Yeah. So when you worked at SeaWorld, didn't you ever feel like, you know, you just wanted to work, but your boss wanted you to do more than you actually were doing? Like, you're the productive worker, right? Like, you're the productive person.
Oh, well, when you get into that system, absolutely.
Yeah, right? You're the productive one.
That pyramid system, and again, I did that. I worked government. I hated that.
And they paid you nothing while they were all reaping the profits.
So, I quit that. I went government. Couldn't do that for a life. Quit that. Went private. Couldn't work for my bosses. So then I started my own company.
Yeah.
That's just, you know, was it hard? Yeah. Did I work really hard? Yeah. Did I create a life for myself where I've created freedom, financial freedom, time freedom? Yes.
Every worker should have that.
And I had to work, but I had, it took me 15 years to create that.
Yeah, I agree. No, but we're in agreement.
I think the problem with Marxism is it disincentivizes people to create. And creativity is the spice of life in life. Regardless, now, you could argue that society should enable that in some shape or
form.
Yeah,
like wealth redistribution,
but again,
so that these billionaire fucks don't make all the money.
I mean, listen, you can see they're all cyclists. I mean, they're just, this is the duality we live in. You have service to self and service to others, and you pick your path.
Yeah.
And a lot of times we're in between both.
Yeah.
You know? It's not an easy world we live in. It really is not.
Well, thank you so much. For
thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Have a good one.
Hey,
boom.
Can we get one blast of that to blow some
darkness? Yeah, hit us with that conch. Beautiful. Yeah.
You know what's crazy? My guru could do it for like 45 seconds.
That's nuts.
Breathing.
That guy, he's not getting COVID. That's for sure.
Well, and that's true. When you do have the breath.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.
Good oxygenation. Have a good one. Good oxygenation levels on that guy. God damn, it's loud. Anyway, let's see.
And was questioning him, like, you know,
no, the thing you do to get into the club, but I can't.
Something happened. I think what they're saying.
Look at Clinton News Network.
Look at Child Protective Services. Gotta be exposed.
That guy's a CNN guy. I love his content. I watch it all the time. Ooh, let's see. Satan lies. That's true. That is a bit reductive, isn't it? Okay, let's see. Who should we? Oh, there is a. This is how the sausage is made. Ladies and gents, this is how the fucking sausage is made. Sausage is also made in the factories where children are being abducted. This is how the sausage is made as well, right, you know,
Mac? I'm not gonna lie, if I didn't have the mask, there's a few times where I broke laughing.
Oh, yeah.
One day when she's like, what are the kids in these masks?
Yeah. No, it's great. Yeah, our dear leader Donald Trump is currently doing a brave and beautiful press conference, but I will be taking a look at that later in the day. Unfortunately for now, I'm out here with a bunch of brave freedom truth tellers who are speaking out against what the demon rats refuse to speak out against, pedophilia. The demon rats are not speaking out against it. All right, let's see. Should we talk to this lady? Who else should we talk to?
Just set up right here and get part of that.
We're storming IKEA tomorrow morning. Sunday is it October 11th at 10:30 a.m. IKEA. Check out Peggy Hall's site, The Healthy American. She has tons of YouTube on how to behave. This is a peaceful demonstration. We are just testing for our rights.
Let's go to someone else. Oh, that guy's got a Q shirt on. I want to talk to him after.
They don't like that duck. Yeah, they have to have the film. Yeah, it's like, I don't
Pedophile treatment center.
Well, it's Douglas just Go
a wood chair.
I see that. Yeah. And plus, good
it
stuff.
Also gives you a non-biased you know, we know through many conservative outlets.
This guy's actually really good to CNN. Dude.
That's how we dig supply. You got something in that really manipulates in certain results to deliver a certain narrative. We know that.
Let's go talk to some other people. I do want to talk to him after, though. I think he's got some good ideas. You can tell who's a journalist immediately. Because they got muzzles on. Isn't that ironic? All the journalists got muzzles on. I wish we could muzzle them, brother.
That essentially is every mainstream network. So, no matter how you put it, it's coming through there.
Yeah, exactly. I showed my family the Troy Feldman documentary.
Like, told them about it?
Yeah.
Do you guys wanna perhaps do an interview about what's going on here today?
Yeah, no.
I'm an independent outlet. I'm not like CNN or anything. No?
No.
No?
I'm camera shy.
You're camera shy? Why? Okay, if you don't want to do it, it's fine. But you have a very cool necklace. I love that. What
Thank
is that?
You. This is.
Is that shungite?
I love shungite, but this is iron pyrite.
Oh, what does that do? Does that block out the 5G waves? I got shungite all over my La Casa, my home. You know.
Me too. I have it on my phone. It does block out 5G waves.
You have it on your phone? Can I see?
Yeah.
I have it all around the La Casa, you know.
Tiny pyramids.
People always mistake it. Whenever I talk about Shungite, they're always like, Suge Knight. And I'm like, no, that guy's locked up in prison. You know?
These are my Shungite.
Wow, and it says self-love on it, too.
It does, yeah.
That's pretty cool. So what are you doing here today?
I am standing up for the children, for all the children who can't speak up for themselves. I'm taking my time out of my day to stand up for them and to stand up for the fact that this is wrong, what they're doing. Netflix is airing this film.
Yeah.
Still, they won't take it down.
I think there was an indictment or something, right?
I think in Texas, they're. It's child pornography. It's what's in the film consists of child pornography. So,
yeah.
It shouldn't be allowed to be aired, you know?
So, how did you find out about the event?
I found out about it. Told me about Scotty, and then I followed his Instagram.
All right, you guys, I'm gonna have you guys come down here. We're gonna start marching. I'm gonna have you guys come down here. We're gonna start marching.
Are you a Democrat or are you a liberal or conservative?
I'm not a Democrat anymore.
You're
I used
not.
To be Risa Convert, but I
What changed, if you don't mind me asking?
Oh, just all this nonsense, the Black Lives Matter protests, and, you know, the looting and the rioting, and then everyone hating Trump. I think that if the media
start is so bad on demonizing him, then we're going to start our march. Right. We're starting the march. And let's go. Let's move it. Let's get it going.
And I think that is the darkest shadow.
Wait, can you repeat that last part? Sorry, Scotty was being a little liberal on that megaphone.
Thank you, guys. We're going to keep moving down this way.
I'm voting for Trump because he's taking down the pedophile rings. And that is the most important issue to deal with because it connects to adrenochrome and all the darkness in the world. It's
so
the darkest
shadow. So how did you find out about all this, though? I mean, this is all, like, really secret information.
I've been researching it for years. I've been knowing what's going on for years, and finally the truth is coming out. And awareness is key. Awareness is the first step to healing all this darkness. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Is she storming IKEA, Andrew?
Yeah, she's storming IKEA.
That's cool. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome. What are you guys?
I'm just an independent. Yeah, okay. I'm an independent outlet.
So, what do you think?
None of that CNN fake news.
What do you think of this protest?
Wait a second.
I hate the exploitation of children. Absolutely. I'm anti, but I'm a little bit further than a lot of these guys, including Scotty. I don't even like child pageants, so.
Oh yeah, no.
I don't like child beauty pageants either. What do you think about that?
I think they're horrible.
Oh, I agree. Thank God. Thank God there's some other people out here who feel this way. What about you, brother? You were looking at me earlier saying
I'm thinking
know.
That you're from TYT? What?
Oh, shit. Hold on. Sorry. What's happening?
Maybe I could. There's down there. Yeah.
Hi. Hold on.
You can't even report the facts on daily.
Yo. Are you CNN? Oh, dude. Okay.
Sorry?
No. I was gonna say, I hope they keep making you do the Facebook videos that, or not Facebook videos, the videos on people who are on Facebook. It's very good. I'm independent. I'm an independent truth teller.
Okay.
I'm independent. If you want, I can give you an interview. I can take this off.
YouTube channel?
Flip the script. No, I'm on Twitch. Twitch.tv/Hasanabi.
Wait, what's your name? Knew it.
What are you talking about? That's not. Hey, you. Shut your mouth.
What's your name?
Hassan. Hassan Piker.
Sorry?
Hassan Piker.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I think I've come across you.
I've come across you.
Wait, did you do, were you doing my Irish accents?
Fake news bastard. What?
Were you doing my Irish accents?
Yes, I was.
It was a very good accent.
Thank you. Okay, hey, you fucking hear that? He's straight from the motherfucking mouth.
I played it as one of my friends said to me last week. I know you're recording it.
No, don't worry about it. You can, I don't give a shit.
I really enjoyed it. Yeah.
Thank you.
It was good.
Thank you for admitting that. That's a real Irishman right there. They keep telling me.
Johnny O'Sullivan.
Yeah, they keep telling me, don't start your car tomorrow. I heard you're disrespecting the provost.
Nice to meet you. You know
what? Yeah, I do, yeah.
Yeah, I enjoyed the video. I think I followed you on YouTube afterwards. So.
Oh, cool. Yeah, no, I love what you're doing.
So, are you into this stuff or are you? This is not on the record.
But yeah, I don't give a shit. It can be on the record. It's literally on the record. But, oh no! Drone down! Drone down!
Drone down!
Obabe!
Drone down!
That's Obabe! I didn't know you were out here. I thought you'd fly around, right?
Yeah. New York.
What happened? That guy was trying to, like, fucking murk you.
I asked him about Tom Hanks, and, I said, you got him on your sign. What's the proof? And then he said Epstein flight logs, and I said, well, was he on the Epstein flight logs? And he said, no, those flight logs aren't out there. So I said, then how do you have the connection to it's just, you know, so you got pissed off.
Yeah. Yeah, I would be too. Clinton News Network.
All right. Nice to talk to you.
All right. Hey, nice to meet you guys. That's awesome. I love that guy. Yeah. Hey, there you go, you fuckers. You keep saying my Irish is not good. Straight from the mouth of babes. There's an Irish man right there who said it was great. What the fuck are you on about?
There's a guy just recording naked from his window right here.
He was?
No, right here. This guy's living the dream.
Oh god. Oh, he is naked. Yeah. Should I talk to the cute guy with the shirt? I feel like...
I mean, okay. If you're going to talk to him, you can't look for gotchas. You just got to let him talk his crazy.
I think I'm doing relatively well with the gotchas. I'm not like the...
I'm just saying with that guy, you don't want to escalate and have a break.
I
mean,
I kind of do.
Okay, well then go for it.
We'll see.
It's time to draw the line.
The fucking American flag socks, the New Balance dad shoes.
Not only New Balance, made in USA, brother.
Hell yeah, brother. Okay, so talk to me. What's going on here? Pedal wood?
Yep. We got CNN behind this spewing more fake news.
Leading News Network.
Yep. It's
That's
insane.
What I was saying.
It's insane.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
That's what I'm saying. So you got, we got Clinton News Network. Oh no, it's a. Are we crossing?
No, we're good.
Yeah, these guys will save us, right? Yeah, this peaceful protest, the cops will protect us, right?
Yeah, we're good.
Yeah. Yeah, no bad people out here. So, all right, so talk about it. What's going on? Pedal wood, your silence is deafening, save our children, cancel Hollywood.
Yeah, man. I mean, like I was talking to those fake news bastards back there, hundreds of thousands of kids go missing every year.
So some of these I see, I'm used to seeing these names, you know?
Yes.
You got Barack Hussein Obama.
Yes.
You got,
You got Oprah, you got Jim Carrey, you got,
But that's what I don't get. So all these guys?
You know, there's even a bigger list than this, but yeah, I mean, if we talk about Oprah Winfrey, look at her connection with the John of God in South America and his human trafficking relations and connections. You know, why would a prolific American TV star have connections with a human trafficking priest in South America?
I have no idea. I have no answer for this.
Yeah, we have the NXIVM sex cult, which was exposed a few years ago with Keith Raniere. He also has connections with the John of God. He has connections with Fiji. The list goes on. You know, it's hard to really just,
Who else you got on there? I'm trying to find out. Will Ferrell? No!
I know, I was shocked.
No! What happens when you find out about your favorite celebrities being pedophiles?
Dude, I can't even watch Old School anymore.
No!
Yeah, it's tough. No, but seriously.
You gotta separate the art from the artist. Oh.
Hard to do.
Hit me again, brother.
Yeah, it's hard to do that, man. No, but seriously, there's an Adult Swim skit. A long time ago, excuse me, where he was talking about selling clowns. But in that instance, clowns were children, and there was nothing but crying children in the background. He talked about shoving them into the trunk and stuff. It's like
that was on Tim and Eric, right?
Yes.
Okay. Like he knows.
Even for comedy, what kind of sadistic person does that shit? It makes zero sense. Why even put that message into the main waves?
So you think they should ban that sort of stuff or what?
You know what? Anything involving children in a negative light should not be presented to the general public, in my opinion.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, we have cuties. Thank God there was an indictment in Texas. But that's just one of many. I mean, you literally have TikTok where you have...
perverts.
Yes, exactly. You have literally those pedophiles, you know, just swamping that social media network, looking at these underage girls dancing. They don't even have to be nude, but that's child porn for them. That is child porn.
So how many what percentage of TikTok users are pedophiles, you think?
Well, the thing is, a lot of these users can use this app anonymously. Without TikTok knowing they're a user.
We should definitely ban anonymous platforms, for sure.
Yes, so...
But wait, wouldn't that ban 4chan too, though?
Well, I'm not saying anonymous platforms. I'm saying there's ways for these people to be on there as a user that doesn't get registered as like a user.
So don't they used to have child porn on 4chan?
I mean, I'm sure they did, but whoever fucking looks at that is a fucked up person. And also,
how do you deal with that though?
Well, it's monitored. Anytime that is posted, they eliminate it completely. Plus, they report it to the FBI immediately.
Wait, but isn't the FBI in on it? Because the deep state that is like trying to take Donald Trump down?
Oh, absolutely. The FBI, the DOJ, they shut down Backpage. They shut down the personal listings on Craigslist. They're shutting down any type of child pornography avenue.
But they also are in on it in the sense that they're like trying to take our president down.
There are factions within those groups. Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, like Jim Comey.
Yeah, but he's gone now. You know, if you look at it, ever since Donald Trump came into power, the main people leading that coup have been fired. You know, they're completely gone. You know, no more involvement with the FBI, the DOJ.
So how'd you come across all this?
QAnon.
How did you come across QAnon?
A family friend told me back in November 2017 and just kind of been following it. You know,
on 8chan or 4chan?
8chan.
On 8chan, okay. Yeah. So wait, if you were all the way on 8chan, didn't you, what's that guy named? Watkins or something?
Who? Jim Watkins?
Yeah, Jim Watkins.
Yes.
Doesn't he own it?
Yes.
Yeah, what do you think about people saying he's Q?
I think that's a joke. 8chan's been around forever, man.
No, I know, but the original creator of it, what's that kid? The dude who has
medical... Code Monkey? Ron?
Yeah, yeah, he...
Well, he's just his son.
No, the other guy who originally created 8chan.
Oh, the other guy?
And brought you a warm Gatorade.
I got you a warm Gatorade? And a Rorschach.
Wow.
I just
want
to say I love you, man.
Oh, thank you
so much. I've been
watching
for the past 2 years, or past year.
Hell yeah. Rorschach, one of my favorite characters. Brave truth teller.
All right,
you too. What?
Is it a Joe Biden voodoo doll?
What? No, it's Rorschach.
Oh, okay.
You left the Joe Biden voodoo doll at home.
Oh, that's too bad. I had some needles. I would have stabbed.
Yeah, I'm stabbing it too.
He doesn't even need the needles. He's so far gone, right?
Good one.
I don't know if you want some warm Gatorade.
Oh, thank you so much,
dude.
Like
orange.
Nice to meet you. You want to take a photo?
Oh, yeah.
All right, let's do it.
I was just talking to Will here.
Dude, I was saying, anyone brave enough to stream snipe us at this, we gotta get a photo.
Well, I didn't realize what was going on until
these people love me too much. I think I'm getting too into the character.
Can't separate the
faces. Have a good stream,
man. Yeah, thanks, man.
You too.
This is awesome.
Yeah. Dude, I literally was, like, he came up and grabbed me, and I was like...
Don't see anything.
And then I noticed he was wearing a mask, and I was like, wait, he's like...
Yeah. That's cool.
So let's.
What?
No,
sorry. I don't want to. I'm not gonna drink it.
It's before my. How's this going so far?
Really good, I think. I mean, I haven't been looking. You want to check the chat, see what they're doing?
Oh yeah.
I think like there is a good group of debate lords who are not understanding what I'm trying to do. So in the chat, they're like, "Dude, why are you letting him get away with all this misinformation?" It's like, dude, that's literally the point. Like,
that's why we're here, baby.
I'm literally trying. I'm trying to have them say whatever. Whatever they believe, okay? That's the whole fucking point.
Alright, chat, we're looking at you right now, so say what you're gonna say.
They're saying drink it.
Someone just said you're platforming.
Yeah, exactly. They're like, you're platforming. And we got good numbers. We got like 27,000 people in here watching. It's pretty cool. Our brave boy.
Drink the Gatorade.
Our brave boy's in the blue. You see that?
Catch up.
Why? Come on. Why do you fucking call me, dude? Like, why? Why?
Just a lot of reeing. Hey, Will. Hi, Stagnation.
Just a lot of reeing.
Hey, Hassan.
What's going on? I don't know who Hassan is. I'm Hank. Nice to meet you.
Hank, I love your show.
Oh, thank you.
I like your fit, man. You look like you could hop on a train right now and just send it.
Somebody actually asked if it was on the Trump train.
There you go.
Yeah. We all are today. All of us.
It's interesting. I feel like I'm going to work for National Geographic.
Why is that? Oh, got it.
Actually, one of the guys, I guess the guy that,
This is wild that like so many people are here on a Saturday. It's great. Right? There's a crazy amount of people here. I barely woke up. I had a hard time.
Like
sign up?
Yeah.
Well, you made it.
Well, I did. And I'm waking up more. Every moment that I'm here, I'm getting more awake.
Wake up.
Yeah. What about you? What, how did you get started in all this?
Long story, man. It's been a long journey.
You want to tell me? How you, or no, it's fine if you don't
no,
want
to. No, because I'm losing my voice and I gotta sing.
Yeah, you're right. What's up?
No.
It's like there's a line. There's a line I don't want to cross where I'm endangered.
Okay.
And I think that crosses it. Look at these poor service industry people that are like, yeah, we gotta serve while.
Yeah.
I think this is pretty good. Most people have no idea who the fuck I am.
No, you're
hey.
Yeah. From TruthEagleFuck.net.
Truth Teller Eagle Fuck.
People from the ruling class, and you're distracting us with race thing. This is a socioeconomic indifference. And you all know that if you're black,
tell
you
us, sister.
Can do anything. Tell everyone, tell these intelligent black men that they can't be what they want to be in America. Good luck with that. You guys know that. Thank you.
Tell them.
Listen, truth doesn't wait for brunch to be over.
Oh no, yeah.
Truth does not wait for
sometimes
brunch.
You gotta yell at people who have
a
brunch.
Lucifer's pizza, how about that?
Lucifer's pizza,
which
pretty
good. Right
there. Oh, got it.
Wait, so there's different
know what kind of pizza they're selling.
So there's different pizza places, huh? Out around here? Are they doing sex trafficking, you think?
I have no idea what Lucifer's pizza is about. All I know is that I've never eaten here in 100 years.
That scares me, yeah. I bet Hillary Clinton would like to eat there, though.
Her and Barack Obama both.
Oh, yeah. Barack Hussein Obama.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because, yeah. I don't know. I just, it's...
Are you Republican, if you don't mind me asking?
Am I a Republican?
Yeah.
Yes, I am.
We always lifelong?
I was born that way. I can't help it.
Born patriot.
Right. I'll tell you when I first came, became a Republican. I was in my politics class in high school in 1973.
Uh-huh.
And our politics class was trying to tell us the difference between Democrats and Republicans. And he told me, or he told our class, if you like the way you live now, you'll probably be a Republican. And I looked around all my class and we all said, yeah, we like it. We're you know, so
seems a little biased there.
Well, I mean, I don't know, but after that,
that's why I'm against public education. I think that they're indoctrinating our children. But luckily, you saved yourself.
They are.
Yeah.
So
that's why I'm more of a fan of homeschooling myself because.
Well, I worked in a Christian rescue mission, and we had a homeschooling program there, and our kids did very well. So, I think that was probably one of the top three greatest days of my life is when I met Jesus. And what can you say? That's I'm not a super Christian, but I'm a believer and I know what He can do.
Think about the numbers.
I prayed the night before the election and I just said, Lord, I can't understand what would happen if she, you know, Hillary became president. I said, but your will be done, not mine. I woke up in the morning, I went to bed before the election was even close to being over.
Yeah, you were confident, huh? You were.
No, I was lost.
Just put in God's hands.
Yeah, I just said,
God's
you know.
Plan.
I woke up in the morning, my wife said, he won. And, you know, it was amazing.
So you think he's been doing good?
Has Trump been doing good? Considering the alternative, he's doing great.
And okay.
We
watch out for the bombing. Yeah, oh, God.
I'm a Trump supporter. Nobody in our family, our friends are all Democrats. We don't talk politics.
Oh, okay, but you're still friends with them. Like, you can still maintain a relationship.
Why not, right?
Uh-huh.
You know what they got to do is they got to take politics out of sports. You know?
Yeah, kneeling for the national anthem.
Well, they just need to take politics out of every sport, right?
So like, you know, national anthem being played, and that's kind of politics too, though, isn't it?
No, that's real politics.
So we got to take that out, you're saying?
What, the national anthem? No.
Yeah.
No, they need...
Isn't that political?
No, that's...
What about the planes flying over?
You know what? I think if people want to... If they want to kneel for the flags, we should stop... I mean, we should stop sending... Our flyovers.
Oh, you want to stop the flyovers?
Yeah, if they want to kneel for the national anthem, stop the flyovers.
No, I agree. I mean, you're right. No more flyovers if they're kneeling.
Right.
Just kneeling, no flyovers.
Right. If you want to kneel, go inside the stadium so we don't have to see.
Yeah.
Right?
So, I take it you're not a big fan of the Black Lives Matter movement.
You mean Bums Lives Matter?
Ooh, okay.
Is that what it is?
Do bums' lives matter?
Of course, we all matter.
Oh, okay. That's good.
You know? My son-in-law...
He's a bum?
He's a sheriff in Portland, Oregon.
In Portland?
Yeah.
Two
counties west. Portland defunded their police. So what do? They call his sheriff's department and rent them to come over and do their police work.
They got that Antifa sheriff, Ted Wheeler.
Right.
Not sheriff, but a police commissioner, right. Ted Wheeler.
Well, he's the mayor.
Yeah, and the police commissioner.
Right, right.
So he's basically in charge of it.
So after the first night of getting feces and bags of urine thrown at him, he said, I'm never going back. And they asked for volunteers, and they offered him double time and triple time, and nobody answered the call.
Wow.
Yeah, so they're on their own.
Portland is, you're saying, yeah. Portland cops. So yeah. Wait, but what do we got to do? We got to protect the cops in Portland then.
Well, the cops in Portland aren't even allowed to go there anymore.
Huh. Who's dealing with it?
I don't know. I live here. So my brother-in-law is the undersheriff for Santa Ana Police Department.
Uh-huh.
And he's ready to retire.
Yeah, they're forcing all these cops to retire because of the mistreatment, I think.
Well, they're not forcing them. They just don't want to work for them.
Yeah, they don't want to work. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, talk about honest guys. You know.
I feel like they do too much. You know, they got too much work that they need to do. They got to like deal with people who are in distress. They got to stop crimes from happening.
My son-in-law saved three people's lives in about 15 minutes one night.
Yeah.
They were all overdosing on fentanyl.
Yeah.
They came walking out of a bar holding their buddy, and he passed out. He went to his police car, pulled out the antidote, walked up, and was starting to administer to one, and his buddy passed out right next to him.
Yeah.
So they had to get two or three of them in side by side.
So I think they should maybe, like... They should maybe make cops do good stuff instead of the bad stuff and all the stuff, you know?
Here's what Antifa did.
What is Antifa?
They put a list on all the power plays. Defund the police. If this happens, call this number. If this happens, call this number. All those numbers went directly to the police department.
Yeah.
They had no idea where they were going.
Paperhead. Oh, I'm hot. It's starting to get... I'm heating up.
It's getting muddy. Should we pop the jackets off?
What? Pop the jackets off.
Where are you guys from?
I'm independent media.
Right.
Come around here.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Good.
California.
First of all, we're a grassroots movement, right?
Yeah.
He's doing everything, right?
Sure.
So I have a couple of friends that are publicists, so I'm going to get in contact with them.
Yeah.
And we're going to ramp it up a little bit, hopefully.
There you go.
If they'll do it. But, and the other thing is, like, we need to notify the police before we have the next one.
Yeah.
You know, just so the police are, informed of what we're doing so they can prepare, right? Because
yeah.
The next one, I hope, is like 10 times bigger than this.
Yeah. Well, you're getting a ton of media attention. That's for sure.
Is there anybody? I mean, I heard CNN was here, but I don't know.
Yeah, they're here.
Yeah, fake news.
They're here spreading that Clinton News Network.
Yeah, well, I heard it was communist news.
There you go. Well, good talking to you, brother. I think we're going to circulate a little bit.
Getting a little hot. Yeah, have a good one.
How much longer do you want to do, brother?
I'm heating up. I love this. I'll do this all day, every day, baby. This is like watching a YouTube video, but instead I'm doing it on my own, and I can literally have these combos. So,
you want to do 30 more minutes? Because then I got to probably go.
Oh, true. What time is it right now?
It's almost 12.
Okay. Maybe we can do a little bit more. We did walk a lot.
Yeah.
We did walk a lot.
You guys might want to cover. There's the windows up there still broken out from the BLM. Right.
Well, I wasn't doing much. The peaceful, y'all walking. Peaceful I figured I'd come and walk with y'all for a minute, man.
Yeah.
Good to see that there are still some balls in Hollywood here.
Our kids are not for sale.
I think the worst part about this is the onlookers looking at us like, what the fuck are you doing?
A lot of people honking. A lot of people honking.
There's a lot of support. But also there is a healthy amount of people who are looking at this group and going, this is psychotic.
Okay, they do.
Got our boys in the blue right here. Keep protecting it, serving it.
Thank you.
What was that?
They're auxiliary officers. They're loss prevention officers. They're basically like cops that protect Target and CVS from onlookers and Black Lives Matter activists alike.
Lollygaggers.
Yeah.
Procrastinators.
Sugared lip tarts driving by. I have never been more afraid of getting COVID than this moment.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
I just want to douse myself in hand. I'm going to put it on my face.
I want to shower in hand sanitizer. Jesus with a bunch of kids?
Yeah.
What's he doing with all these kids?
He's saving the children worldwide.
Yeah.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I love Jesus Christ.
Good.
Yeah. Lord and Savior.
Great.
He's a little bit more brown than this depiction, but hey, I'll let it slide.
I found this on Instagram, and I was going to do some, like, Old Testament, like, dark stuff on one side, but I got too scared, man, so I just put him on both sides. I found it on Instagram, and I just, you know, printed it.
But Jesus wasn't that white, you know that.
Yeah, I agree. I agree.
I kind of like the Bob Ross Jesus, though. He's friendly looking.
Scary.
That's what I heard about. Hey, we don't know, right? Until we see it.
No,
right?
We don't. So, from what I understand, the big, like, the leaders of the movement are now no longer associating with QAnon.
Right.
And that probably comes at the heels of Facebook banning all mentions of QAnon in general, but a lot of the people on the ground have not necessarily gotten the memo, so they are still, of course, very much avid supporters and even wear the merchandising and whatnot. However, I feel as though the movement is now relegated to the shadows. I think that it's probably impacting their mobilization quite a bit, with the exception of these talking heads, of course, that are basically vectors of organizing that people are following here.
Yeah, I'm burning up.
Dude,
I've been carrying that fucking bag all day. Shit is.
Let me do it. I'll be the pack mule. I'm low to the earth.
Anti-maskers, they got some good ideas, man. This is, I'm fucking burning up. Let's say they're not incorrect about how hot it is. My oxidization levels, I feel like they're decreasing. Woo!
They do. You can take them to a therapist. Your kid is killing cats.
Yeah. How are you guys doing? You guys some good?
Yes, dude.
Let's talk to them. Let's talk to them. They're not going to want to do that. You know what I mean?
Grab him in the interview.
Where's that for us?
We gotta get Scotty the Kid, who is a rapper. We gotta get him to rap.
I'm gonna do a long interview with him.
Yeah, it'll be long. He loves it. If you know what I'm saying.
Oh, we're here at CNN headquarters.
Whoa! Fake news! Clinton News Network!
What is your Instagram?
All gas, no brakes. What is it?
Yeah. We're gonna try to get a Where are the Kids CNN chant going.
Where are the kids?
Where are the kids CNN?
Let's get this.
Okay, I'm fucking way too hot now.
It's getting a little hot.
This mask.
Oh, I know, dude.
So constricting.
I hate that.
Yeah, but, you know, who knows? Like, what if I have a light cough and, you know what I mean? I want to protect others.
Hey, bro, I don't mind, dude. I think it's bullshit anyways.
So if I was coughing around, you wouldn't care?
No.
Really?
Because I don't believe in it.
You don't believe in it at all?
No. I believe you take care of your body, you can fight anything.
Wait, what about the president then? You think he got it?
It's bullshit.
Watch out, we can't show the butt. We can't show the sexual image,
right?
I know, but still, we can't show it, and then we'll get banned. They don't want truth tellers. They don't want truth tellers on this platform, so yeah, that's fine. That's fine. Anyway, so you think Trump don't have COVID?
No, absolutely not.
What do you think is going on? Why did they,
shit, but like I said, in my opinion, there's a higher power just controlling it all. It's like a movie, basically. That's just my opinion.
So, what do you think? So you think the higher power? You think the higher power locked Trump up? Like, what do you think the higher power was trying to do then?
I think they were trying to give the people sympathy for Trump. Like, oh, he got it. Like, oh shit. Like, you know, this whole like thing to try to relate to him. And he's.
Do you think he was unsympathetic before that? Then, I mean, I love Trump.
Issues, but I'm just saying that truthfully, I'm just seeing it from an outside perspective. That's all. I'm not a political person at all. I don't know shit about politics. I'm just saying, just from my outside.
So you think Trump was unsympathetic, and now they were like getting him sympathy
for the Democrats, trying to get them. You know what I mean?
So like, you're not a voter.
I'm not a voter.
bit.
Bitcoin, bro.
Oh, yeah.
We don't support that. SB 1145
Russo in California.
We don't support that. We protect our children.
We don't
support that.
Yeah.
We're educated. Protect you.
Oh,
let's
go talk to
him. What's your situation? You want to leave, or I mean, I'm really feeling this, but obviously I'll leave with you. I'm not gonna stay here by myself.
I got like another 20 minutes, so.
Okay, yeah. Yelling at the brunching black people. The lady who was yelling at the black people who were brunching. There is a surprising amount of... Holy fuck, where's that guy come from? Thank you.
guys doing here today?
We're protesting to save our children. Cool. Cool. Like
your mask. Oh, thank you. Unmute us. Exactly. They're trying to muzzle us. Why aren't you wearing a mask right now?
Because this is my mask.
Okay. Well, why are you wearing one then?
This is how I feel.
You don't think it's a preventative measure for COVID at all? What do you guys think? I'm scared, but I'm a pussy, so like that's why I'm wearing a mask. You know, I'm fragile. I got bad lungs. You know? Yeah. So. From other scientists.
Yeah, if everyone's gonna go and jump out of the room, are you gonna jump too? No, you should do your own research.
Yeah, like if everyone was not wearing masks, you're gonna wear a mask.
If you feel like this is a great moment to wear a mask, or you wear a mask, but you do it because you wanna do it, not because someone says you do it.
Yeah. So how did you guys find out about this project?
When it comes to abortion, it's your body. When it comes to a mask, it's not your body, your choice. When it comes to a vaccine, it's not your choice.
I think they say that because public health, because like abortions aren't contagious. I don't know. I don't agree, but I think that's why they say it.
I mean, I think they say it for their own agenda, what works for them.
Unless you think like, you know, you see Sally getting an abortion and they're like, I want one too, you know?
Well, that's what they want for. They for sure want everyone.
Yeah, they want everyone to get abortion. Yeah.
So they have more fetuses so they can, you know, eat more babies and do God knows what with them.
You think they're eating them?
Yeah, they're for sure eating them.
For sure, okay.
Actually, Kamala Harris, she was on the case that the news reporter went into Planned Parenthood and tested like that they are selling fetuses.
Oh, Project Veritas.
What?
Project Veritas.
Yeah.
Yeah,
she took all his material.
Yeah, that came out to be fake news, though. I'll be careful because I thought so, too. I agreed with you, and I thought that they were selling babies and fetuses. But then they got sued and lost.
Yeah, but just Kamala Harris, she decided that because she's Planned Parenthood is her sponsor for the campaign.
So you think they're using stem cells and the adrenaline drug?
And also some babies, because in America you can do an abortion up to 9 months. The day before you give birth, you can decide to do an abortion. They take it out, and before the baby's out, they inject it and kill the baby and then pull it out, and then they say, now the baby's dead, so it's an abortion. But sometimes babies are still alive when they take the baby. They still have a heartbeat.
Do you think Joe Biden's using those adrenal glands and stem cells?
I think so, for sure. He's a...
Why does he look like shit then?
I know, right?
They're not getting it yet.
It's not working well for him right now. He's
wait, so did you hear about Regeneron then? What Donald Trump is taking right now for COVID?
Yeah.
I heard that company, Regeneron, works on stem cells, like literally on fetuses, on stem cells and stuff.
So actually with the stem cells, I'm not quite sure, but they say they take it from the umbilical cord. So in the hospital, if you give birth and you donate your umbilical cord, they give you a discount of your hospital bill.
So what do you think about Donald Trump potentially getting medication from stem cells then?
Well, his medication is steroids. It's not
no,
stem
no, no, no.
Cells.
That's dexamethasone. And then he also has Regeneron, which is a monoclonal antibody treatment. And that treatment is from the company Regeneron. They're a biopharmaceutical. which means they work on stem cells, which means they, like, on some of their treatments they work on, like, this one specifically is kidney tissue off of, like, mice. I think that's crazy too. Yeah, but that's
crazy.
That's what they pumped the president with. What if he's a clone now?
Well, honestly, I do believe in our president. I think what he's trying to do with this, he's trying to show us, he's put himself as a guinea pig, showing there is a treatment. You have a choice.
So you'll take the vaccine then?
I will never take that vaccine.
What if it's Donald Trump, but he took it?
He did not took a vaccine. He took the medication. He took the steroids. And then you still have the hydroxychloroquine, right? With the
He didn't take hydroxychloroquine.
He took the steroids. But steroids is used with pneumonia. When you have bad pneumonia, they give you that to breathe.
You mean pneumonia.
Yeah.
So no, it's all good. Don't worry about
it. So you think the president is using this as a way to show us that there's a treatment of it?
He is, he's putting himself out there, because if you have a normal person, one of us, and we get cured and we voice that, it's not going to...
Do you think the government should make that treatment available to the public for free?
Yeah, I think so. For people that have it very bad, that need the medical treatment, then they have it, that they need it. But also, most people, it's a 99.99 survival rate, this virus.
Yeah.
Most of us will survive it. Most of us will have it, and you don't even know you have it.
So do you think they should make treatments available for the public for more dangerous conditions?
No, for everyone. Everyone who needs a treatment should be able to get the treatment.
Okay.
Yeah.
Same as if you want a vaccine, then go for it. But
it's starting to sound like a Democrat, by the way. Watch out. Talking about how everyone should get a treatment.
Yeah.
No, you should be able to want it, to get it if you want it.
But Trump said he wanted to be for free.
Yeah, that's what I mean, for free. A lot of people don't, have the money for it.
Yeah.
But I do.
So, like, free healthcare.
I think most important, I always say this, just if you put so much effort in wearing your mask as being healthy, then you wouldn't even get it. Just drink your vitamins, eat healthy, work out, go outside in the sun, be in nature.
Yeah.
It's really that simple.
Little guy right here. Little patriot.
Right?
Well, thanks so much for talking to us.
Thank you, guys.
Appreciate you.
All right. Thank you. What else? A couple other people I think we can interview. Oh my god, I'm getting so hot.
Yeah, it's fucking scorching. Oh, she's singing.
Oh, she is? Killed it. 55% of business is permanently closed.
What's up?
I'm just reading your sign. 55% of business is permanently, small business is permanently closed. Time to open. I agree. 55% of small business.
This was about a month ago.
Yeah, I think they're. It's a little bit less now, right? Or
I don't know.
But yeah, what do you think about all that?
Think we need it all?
Who do you think is at fault?
I think a lot of people are at fault, including us.
Why are we at fault?
Because we've been too compliant with the government. The lockdown, too dependent on the mainstream media, the news, not doing our own research, and we're too reliant on the experts, quote unquote, who are being paid off a lot.
So who do you trust then, if you can't trust the experts?
You gotta trust your own research, And you gotta, but there's conflicting sources, like hydroxychloroquine,
let me answer
vaccines.
About that. So I'm a big hydroxy believer, or I was rather. Remember Dr. Stella Emanuel?
Yeah.
And like all the other doctors that came up like 2 months ago, and they were like, hydroxychloroquine, it's really good. And then Donald Trump got it. And then they didn't give him that. So what the fuck?
That's a little strange as well.
Yeah, I found that. Whoa, so you don't think he even got it?
Maybe he did get it. I don't know.
I think he got it. Because why would he?
He got Remdesivir and Regeneron. Right?
Yeah, he got Remdesivir, Regeneron, which is a monoclonal antibody. And he also got dexamethasone, which is a steroid.
Yeah.
And I was waiting. Like, I was like, he's going to get hydroxychloroquine.
That would have been a good...
It's going to save him. and he didn't.
He said he's been taking hydroxychloroquine.
No. The doctor said he wasn't.
Yeah. Really? No,
yeah.
He himself said it. He said, I've been taking.
No, I know, but that was months ago.
Yeah.
And doctors this time
well,
around.
Maybe, I don't know. I'm not sure, but there's been tons of research, hundreds of research on hydroxychloroquine around the world.
I just think it's strange because, like, I was waiting for Dr. Stella Emanuel to come in and save him, you know, like the group of doctors they
yeah,
had.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then when he was getting treated by his own team instead, I thought that was kind of bullshit.
That's just, guess what? Lancet.
Supposedly leaked.
Lancet retracts their hydroxychloroquine statement.
Yeah,
that's the Federalist. Ivy League epidemiology professor, hydroxychloroquine is the key to defeating COVID-19. That's news. Data showed remarkable results if hydroxychloroquine were given to patients. COVID-19 study with more than 6,000. That's another study.
Let me hear what
that Henry Ford, that's another study.
I know. Study after study. I'm on the same team. So I agree.
Treatment with hydroxychloroquine. Tons of it.
I agree, but then when push came to shove, I'm with you.
I don't know.
I don't know why. It freaked me out a little bit. You think he might be a clone?
Not a clone. No.
I don't know.
Like President Trump's a clone.
I don't know. I mean, no. Might be. I read a lot of this Q stuff. They're talking about how Tom Hanks is a clone.
Q has a lot of connections with the New Age. They say a lot of good stuff, like child trafficking, but a lot of the stuff that they say is literal like the bad side of conspiracy theories.
So you don't think like clones are real?
It could be, but like, I wouldn't say President Trump's a clone. Like, that's pushing it, you know what I mean?
But Mike Pence might be.
I don't think Mike Pence is a clone. That's pretty far out there.
Okay.
You know, shape-shifting lizards are controlling the elites. I mean, you know, Queen Elizabeth is a lizard when she's hiding from people. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. No, okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, and a lot of it comes from a New Age and a theosophical society.
Wait, doesn't David Icke say that they're all lizards?
Exactly.
Though?
David Icke used to say it. People don't know it.
So do you believe in the lizard thing,
no,
then?
No.
But you
problem,
have it on
the
there.
Problems that David Icke talks about, a lot of it is true, but a lot of the stuff that he brings out, the occult stuff, is totally false. People don't know that.
Yeah.
Zeitgeist. The Zeitgeist.
You know, I'm not seeing one person's name on there, and I'm afraid I'm going to call you out on this. Where's my boy Alex Jones?
Alex Jones is great. I love Alex Jones.
Why is he not on there? You didn't want to put him on the...
No. David Icke is part of the New Age.
Oh, these guys are ops.
They are ops.
Oh, okay. Wait. Oh, you confused me because I was like, I like some of these guys.
No.
These are all New Age operations. Jordan Maxwell... Theosophical Society. He follows the Satanist Helena Blavatsky's teachings. David Icke. He does the same thing. He follows Lucius Trust, Lucifer Publication Company,
Alex
or the United Nations.
But
Alex Jones has some sketchy people on his show sometimes here and
like
there.
Who?
But
who does he have?
David Icke yeah. And Jordan Maxwell and some occult people. And
you're opening up my eyes, brother.
Yeah, but Alex Jones, I've been listening to him since 2008.
Yeah.
And he's legit. I'm
He changes sure. points a little bit.
Like what?
On the police state.
Like the against the police and all that?
Yeah,
he used to be
big
but,
anti-book.
You know, he's not perfect. He's not 100% perfect in what he says, but he... Most
he was,
of the stuff that
he
says
right.
he means well. He's
he was right on. He was right on the government surveillance, but
he was right on Bill Gates.
I think that
he was right on Bill Gates and the vaccines.
Oh, Bill Gates!
5 years ago, he was talking about it.
What was he? What was he saying?
That Bill Gates works for the vaccine company, and his goal is to push vaccines for the entire world population.
What do you think about Elon Musk then?
I don't know that much about him. So
he's doing
really
this like Neuralink thing.
Yeah, I don't know about that. I think we're technologically advanced, comfortable, you know, with our phones and all that.
Yeah.
We don't need anymore, you know?
Yeah, I mean, they're tracking everything we're doing on our phones. Yeah,
anymore,
you know?
I mean, it's crazy enough, just leave it the way it is. Should I change so this looks like these guys are...
Yeah, I thought you were in support of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to change that, brother. You've been running around. How long have you been out there with this?
Oh, a lot.
Like how many months, give or take?
Like 3 months.
3 months?
Yeah.
So you've been running around with this for 3 months. People probably think, they probably searched all this now.
Yeah, it's all right. That's all good. Because once they hear the new age, yeah, Lucius Gross, they'll
All right, next time I see you, that better be, it's just Alex Jones all the way.
Yeah. Well, no, I'm not going to put Alex Jones there.
No, you got to take that out or make sure that everybody knows that they're liars.
So you're saying that, like, these are new age people trying to infiltrate the movement?
You think it's the government? Why are they infiltrating?
Yeah,
You think it's the government?
I don't feel like they're infiltrating the government. I mean, a lot of government people are Freemasons, and they believe in what the Freemasons are. Like David, Albert Pike believes in a lot of these things. In his book, Morals and Dogma, he talks about Satan's the real ruler of the world and all these weird occult stuff that they got from the Theosophical Society and the ancient teachings. And now they're repackaging it as a new age or the Great Awakening and things like that. And these are the people who are promoting this stuff.
So, like, the whole Great Awakening thing is, like, repackaged new age stuff?
Yeah, a lot of it is, yeah.
Okay.
I'm learning so much today.
Yeah.
My third eye is open.
Well, the third eye is...
Is that fake, too?
It's a cult.
Oh, God damn it. Okay, I'm going to stop talking.
Here,
Illuminati. Oh, you got paperwork. Okay, we'll take it.
Thank you.
You got it? Thank you. I don't want to. I'm scared.
I can tell.
I got baby lungs, you know?
Yeah, I can tell.
My lungs are not strong enough. I don't know who you're talking about. My name is Hank.
Oh, Hank, I'm sorry. What's up?
I'm Hank from truthteller.com.
TruthTellerEagle.net.
Police shoot hoops, not people? Like, are you saying, like, are you telling the cops to shoot hoops and not people? Or are you saying that they actually shoot hoops and they don't shoot people?
They do shoot people.
Oh, okay. I don't know anymore. There's a lot of people here.
I'm just trying to go to Staples.
You trying to what?
I'm trying to go to Staples.
Oh, yeah. Well, good luck. I think you can get through here.
Yeah. I'm going to sleep by.
Bye. Almost got unmasked there, brother.
There you go, man.
You see that shit? There's ops out here. There's ops everywhere.
Truth Teller
Eagle. Boys in the blue.
Woo. Truth Teller Eagle.
Hell yeah.
Fuck.net. We're out here doing...
If there's any loss happening, I will help you prevent it, sir.
Sorry about that.
I'm an auxiliary officer myself, so if there's any losses going on, I will prevent it from happening. Have a good one.
You guys are doing awesome. You're not blocking traffic. You guys are awesome out here.
Thank you. Are you voting for Donald Trump?
I can't.
Oh, no, don't say it. No.
Confirm or deny.
No, don't say anything. Don't say anything. They're always watching.
I cannot.
What?
On the internet, is your name Hassan? Do you have a Muslim name?
No.
I'm sorry, man.
Hank.
Mistaken for someone else.
Yeah, no. My name is Hank.
Hey, have a good day, brother.
Yeah, you too. What? Are you? Who is this Hassan fellow?
Pardon?
Who is this Hassan fellow?
He does these political videos. I don't know if it's him or not. I don't know if that's you.
Yeah, I love politics, so I always want to know more.
It's just more about he just basically shows, I don't know what side he's really on, but he just speaks the truth on, like, the details of, like, what's really going on. And even if it's, like, left or right, he just says the real, and that's what I mess with.
Sounds like a cool guy.
Sounds dope, bro.
Yeah.
Hey, man, but keep up your shit. Hank,
yeah.
Dope. Hey, man. Tell him. Respect to you, brother.
Yeah, you too.
Don't call me! Don't pedophile! Don't tell! Sacrifice!
I feel bad.
No, truthtellereaglefuck.org, man.
I feel bad. He's still looking back at us. I can't tell if he's a...
Is he a op or...
Oh, Jesus. I don't know. The more we stay here, the more...
Let's get a dance going.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah. You feeling it, brother. Hell yeah.
Yes.
Ooh. I got the same vibe going on with you.
What's up? Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's the white man dance.
Oh, thank you.
White man dance.
Oh, I love that. Oh, you get the day. Oh, shit.
Yes.
Too much dancing. I'm going to... It's a little too much. I'm a little worried. You better stop with that. That's a sin, brother. Save him! Oh, sorry. I kind of want to see if Scotty will do
a little freestyle.
Scotty will do a little freestyle for us, but I don't know if I'll be able to get him to do it. I'm gonna ask him, but I'm gonna try to get Andrew in on it too, so it's not like just me and then he has to do it twice.
You wanna grab him?
Let's go see. Yeah, let's go see if he wants to do it. Sorry. Dude, how do I have fans that believe this shit? What the fuck, dude? That is crazy. I mean, seriously, that shit is crazy. Oh, he's on the...
But is it Hank?
Hank? Yeah, it's me, Hank.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
What's going on, man?
I'm from the stream.
What?
I'm from the stream. I'm one of your viewers.
Oh, cool.
One of your subs, actually.
Oh, cool. Nice to meet you, man.
Yeah. It's really nice to meet you.
You want to take a photo?
Hell yeah.
From the Hank Parker Daycare Hank Center?
You're shaking, dude. You good?
I'm nervous, yeah.
No, don't be nervous. It's all good.
Yeah, I got you, brother. I'll take it.
I watch it every day.
Hell yeah.
One more.
All right, have a good one,
man. I didn't think I was going to catch you guys. I came out a little bit of waste. So I couldn't see you.
Yeah, well,
you got us, man.
You got it.
How long are you going to be here?
We're probably going to leave soon.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got a lot of footage, but he's got to go do some stuff, so.
For sure.
I will. Yeah. They're
oh, they're no. I never heard from earlier.
Yeah, no, they're great. A brave truth tellers out here, all around.
All right, see you guys.
Cool. All right, good meeting you, brother. Nice to meet you. I don't want to believe that. I like that they don't fuck my shit up. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like my snipers, they don't like, they're in on it. Hell yeah, guys.
Way to go, boys.
What?
It's a way to go, boys.
Yeah, I got the best community. I swear to God.
You know, I've heard bad things
guys.
About that Hank Parker Daycare Center. Just yeah. About a piece of goods.
Oh, wait, you want to talk now? About the, hey, man. Yo.
But I'm not going to put all my faith in him. And that's
what do we got? What else we got here? Dude, this has been a journey, dude.
Yeah, I feel like we've both grown as people.
Oh yeah. I just got Dono Wald IRL. True. Yo, Andrew. You wanna? Oh, sorry. You wanna do the? We're gonna leave soon. I don't wanna like double book him with the fucking rapping thing. Do you wanna try to get him to do freestyle now?
Yeah. But I wanna like bring him aside for like 5 minutes.
Okay. Yeah. I just didn't wanna. I didn't wanna go up and like try to get him to do a freestyle and him be like annoyed. You know? No, I don't wanna fuck up your content.
What? Where's he at?
Look over there, dude. It's impossible not to.
Andrew.
We can do it now.
Yeah, sure.
Let me see your phone for double angle.
What?
Your phone.
I don't have any storage.
I'll fix it.
No, I don't have any storage on my phone.
I can get you storage.
If you film through Instagram and yeah. Save it.
Oh, okay.
If my camera works.
That's insane. So hold it
on the story. Hold the story. Hold the button.
That's so funny. You want a second angle?
Here is propaganda!
No, I don't care. Go ahead. No. Here. Hey, man, you want to talk about the thing you were telling me before?
Yeah, but no recording, though.
Oh, no recording?
Yeah, I'll show you some stuff.
It's live. You don't have to show them. You can tell me? Or can you tell me? None of it?
None.
Is that secret?
Yes.
Damn. Okay.
Just look into Walter Reed.
Okay, I will.
Two med beds.
I will.
And why Walter Reed? And look into Kevin Rock.
Yeah, I will. I'll do that. Thank you.
Stay out of the street.
What is this?
Stay out of the road. Respect the police. They're here for us, so we need to respect them. Obey the rules and stay out of the street, you guys, please.
I want to. Oh, they got. I'm gonna put these glasses on to see if I can talk to them, but I don't want them to recognize. I don't want them to recognize me at all.
Well, the glasses are more recognizable. Right?
You think so?
They're counting their signature.
Hey, hold on. Hey, who are you guys voting for? happy Joe Biden. Sleepy Joe. Hell yeah. Why aren't you guys out here with us? We're trying to protect the children.
We've been everywhere. We're with Trump. We're with our cause. We're with human rights. We're just—it's about upholding just basic human rights.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Do you guys? What do you guys think about Corona? Is it real or these Democrats are lying?
But it's not enough to shut down the entire country.
Yeah.
It exists, but it's not enough to have people running around shutting down their businesses. Just like the flu exists too. But you never see anybody running around closing all their businesses because of the flu.
Yeah.
It's a higher death rate.
Yeah, I think they were trying to shut it down early, like quickly, and then reopen it, but I feel like those Democrats, they didn't want to shut it down as quickly.
You know why, right? Because China's trying to come and buy everything out. The more the U.S. shuts down...
So how did China get over it then?
Because they threw it out. Hey, this is what's going on.
I know, but how do they mitigate this spread? I don't know. I'm asking you. This is confusing to me, too.
Everything's confusing. If you look at the whole world, it's all confusing.
Yeah. So how do you think China was able to deal with it better than we did then? How do you think China was able to deal with it better than we did then?
Because it's not as crazy right now. If we want to open this country up to the people, just like they did.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Have a good one.
Oh, sorry. Sorry about that.
Who are
fighting.
Antifa.
It's okay.
It could be
Antifa. It could be BLM. The police are here with
us. They got children in the baskets.
Talk about why we're outside of CNN.
CNN, we're outside of the CNN building on Sunset because they just failed to talk about this. I don't understand how, the number could be a little skewed as far as people saying 800,000 children go missing. It actually is half of that, but half of that is still four times the amount of people that died from coronavirus, and that shut our shit down. So as far as I'm concerned, there is only one, we can't fix every other problem in society until the human trafficking problem is addressed and is fixed, and it's a combat, a war that's never going to end because this is going to continue forever. But the more aware you are, the more you can prevent this from happening to yourself, to your family, to your friends.
What's the connection between this and QAnon?
Everybody has their own theories. I go by statistics. Whether QAnon existed or not, are the numbers still the same on children that are missing? Yes, that's all I care about. Are Biden supporters welcome here? Yes. If they're here to combat human trafficking, that's all I care about. If somebody from planet Saturn's here and they want to fight human trafficking, yes, please join us. Open arms. More than welcome. There's no hate in wanting to help children, and that's all I care about. People try to put labels on everything. Fuck the labels. Labels are your idea of what the picture you're trying to paint of your own reality of that situation. Fuck that shit. Are the kids missing? Are kids going trafficking? Are kids by the handfuls, by the dozens being found in places? And how come we don't hear about that every day? Oh yeah, it's depressing. Well then why are you talking about the bombings over and over and over? Let's talk about the shit that's happening in our backyard, here, right now, in America. Our people that are involved in this are the customers. $150 billion industry. You think any of us, all our money put together, doesn't even equal a billion. So where's all this money coming from? Who has that kind of money? Think about it. Who has that kind of money?
Who do you think controls the money?
The money system, or just you know what? There's a lot of people. There's a handful of people that control the money. You can start with the Federal Reserve and go back from there. The Federal Reserve is a privately owned company, so all you got to do is look into that, look into what's going on there, and find out, and do your own research, and come to your own conclusion. My conclusion is the kids are missing. My conclusion is the kids are being raped. The kids are being sold. There's 30 million human beings right now enslaved around the world. There were 4 million African Americans enslaved during World War, in our American history, during the Civil War. So we're talking about literally 10 times the amount of those slaves internationally, not just nationally, but internationally. 10 million of those people are children. Is that cool? You can go, oh, let me go wake up, have lunch, go hang out with my friends, go smoke, go chill, da da da. While children are being raped, sold, murdered, and killed, like that's happening right now during our generation. If you look at the lifetime, the lifespan of human beings and civilization, you're only here for a little flash in the pan. What did you do? Did we not do anything or say anything? We are. We have to. Because if we don't, who's going to? Who's going to? Who's going to? Is media going to point it out? Help us?
No. Bars.
No. Nobody's going to.
Spitting bars.
We've been waiting for media to say something, do something. Yeah, the little, oh, you know, 20 kids found here. That is a great thing. That is a big deal. But there's way more than that. It's way deeper than that. We're talking about a full-blown system, turnkey, of our children here. All you got to do is the homework, look into it. It's called first-hand information. I can tell you something, and you can try to take it for truth or not, but until you read it with your own eyes and do your own homework, it's not going to hit the soul the way it's supposed to.
When did you know you wanted to devote your life to this?
I'm asking.
Yeah.
When did you know that you wanted to devote your life to this?
Literally about 6 months ago, just being like having a family, you know, helping. My mom's a teacher. My mom has helped thousands of kids. She's taught thousands of kids. I've heard horror stories of that. Things like just being, you know, having a big heart for humanity. And then hearing the numbers and statistics, and I'm just like, this doesn't seem real. These numbers don't seem real. How am I living like a normal life, going about my day, and this is happening on our watch as human beings during our generation? How is that possible? How? How? Because people feel okay because they can turn the other cheek. That's not my kid. That kid belongs to us. We're all human beings. You know what? The closer you're born to the equator, your ancestors, the darker your skin is. If you have a problem with that, you have a mental issue. Because you literally have a mental issue, a psychological issue if you're racist. Because guess what? We burn in a fire, we're all the same fucking color, right? So come on. We're human beings and those are our children, and shit's happening to them and nobody's saying anything. And here we are to combat it. It starts with us. Raising awareness creates prevention, and that's what we're doing.
Thank you, man. And then to switch gears a little bit, I heard you spit bars.
Oh, yeah, a little bit. Okay.
Hell yeah!
Okay. Day by day, I started to notice the way they use COVID to control us. It started with a mask that happened fast, took away our smiles, just like that. Yeah, the awakening is so evident because of all the evidence, manipulated rhetoric. Yeah. This is now the end of it. Baby blood for benefit, mass manipulation of our generation, starting with our nation. No more waiting. Y'all are getting flagrant, buying, selling babies, raping on our children. Afterwards, you kill them. The truth is out, and that's a fact. The false flags will no longer distract. Now the cat is out the bag, ninth life on its last. Media will no longer cover your ass.
Damn.
I got a music video for that song that we just dropped for the whole movement. It's called Youth of the Nation. I got the cosign from POD. So, and we sampled
Who's
Youth
that?
Of the Nation.
POD.
Oh, no. POD?
Who's POD?
Paid Upon Death. It's a Christian rock group from the 90s that kind of had a mainstream hit called Youth of the Nation. It's about gun violence. And I twisted it and I rewrote it as if the children were getting taken rather than them getting shot at school. And so we did our own twist on it and we got a music video for it out. And it's wonderful. It represents everything that this movement is about. It's about the truth. And that's all that we're here for.
And bars.
Oh, yeah. So thank you guys.
Why do you think that so many people have to rally?
Why do I think so many people? Because it's the ability to go to YouTube and look up a beat and, you know, freestyle and have fun on that beat. Hip-hop has come like a long way. There's little kids rapping and stuff like that. It's a form of expression. I grew up freestyling. That was my form of expression. And when kids really can grip onto the translation of their thought while voicing what they're saying on a beat, and you can kind of get that down, it becomes its own form of art as far as like a painter painting a picture. It's your words painting a picture. And, you know, that for me personally as a freestyle rapper in the beginning, that's how I started getting into music.
All right, man, thanks, man.
All right,
We're gonna
start taking
thanks,
this
man.
Down.
No problem.
Hey,
I'll send that.
Hey, dude, we're about to get out of here. Do you want to grab a photo real quick?
Oh yeah, we gotta do a photo. We gotta do a photo. What's up? Wait, this is mine, right? Oh yeah, it is.
How you doing? I gave it to you.
Yo, these guys are dope too. I don't know.
Did you get what you need?
Oh yeah, I got the freestyle.
You got a freestyle. I'm so
dude, I, there's like 40,000 people watching right now. I think I don't know, like. Or 30.
He's actually not that bad. He's got a decent last voice.
Like, that was like,
no, he's terrible. Get out of here.
He's pretty good for like.
Poor guy.
If you say
the rest of his life,
you as far as I'm handling, but.
No. They're much nicer than I am. They do a very good job of like cutting it in a way that it's like humorous, but not like bad or mean.
Should we put you in the middle?
Wait, hold on here. I'll just put this down near you for a second. I don't want to have a moment. Oh, man,
we have Gelato 33 times fucking winning. So, I got cut. Gelato 33.
You guys want to do almost touching fingers but not quite?
Oh, like,
you know, put it as close as possible without making contact. Oh, yeah.
Why does it look like a fucking Nathan cut? No, why does it look
I told you, bro.
Dude, thank you so fucking much.
No, hey, no problem.
We bailed on the Jesus Christ guy for this.
Yeah. But
I'm Will, by the way, guys. It was nice
Let me know about the podcast, and we'll figure it out.
So the RV's getting renovated right now. It'll be done in a week and a half. So as soon as that's done, you'll be one of the first people on.
Fuck yeah. All right, dude.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Yeah, oh yeah.
He's coming on the podcast.
Yeah, can we get some bars?
Right. Yeah, I've been streaming. All right.
All right, boys, we'll good luck.
You want to transfer me that footage later tonight or something?
Yeah, yeah, I got you.
You guys have this way?
We're going
back that way, yeah.
Yeah, me too.
You want to, plug your podcast.
QAnon Anonymous, podcast about QAnon, but we do a bunch of other stuff too. Conspiracies, madness, comedy.
They're leftists. They're a leftist podcast.
Sure, although my other hosts don't want to admit it. But I dominate them a lot, so it's okay.
Yeah, they're Demi Daver.
Are we a leftist podcast?
They were on the Chapo episode last. Hey, peace, guys.
Asked her for her phone number.
Hey, you too. I actually, unironically, like that Sam News coverage.
Oh, yeah, I got the whole post interview where he's actually talking about his tactics with the
I can't wait to react to all this later.
Yeah.
Like on my Twitch. This guy's got drip. All right, peace, boys. Hey, stay safe. Oof. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do exfiltration.
Bro, that is a sick photo.
All right, peace, guys. Ooh. All right, we are going to do an exfiltration, ladies and gentlemen. And then after the exfiltration, I'm going to go through, obviously, once I get home. No, we're not done yet. Obviously, once I get home, I'm just going to... I am going to... Oh, they're going back. Never mind. They're also going back. Yeah. You have hand sanitizer in your car, right?
So much.
Oh, God, I am...
Dude, I might literally shower when I drop you off before I go to this next
thing. I've never been more desperate for hand sanies ever in my entire life, dude.
I'm gonna bathe in it. So what did we learn today?
What the fuck did we learn? Absolutely nothing.
We learned that Sage is at all protests.
Oh, Sage is a big... No, you know what the unique thing is? Okay, I'll be honest with you. You know what I did learn that I knew already? Oh, shit. You know what I did learn? That there's a lot of, like, crystal weirdos that are into QAnon now.
Yeah.
And they are, like... Those communities are being infiltrated on Facebook and shit.
We have to protect our crystal heads.
Yeah, like, crystal mommies. Like, I don't know about the kids, but... I don't know about saving the children, but we definitely need to be saving our crystal mommies.
Yeah.
From the brainwashing that they're getting from the psychos like Dude, this.
Horoscopes are a gateway drug to QAnon.
Actually, I say psychos, but, like, I feel bad because... They just seem like nice people. They're just like duped. You know what I mean?
Yeah, oh yeah.
He's like 400,000 kids get lost every year, right?
Yeah.
In America. Yeah, 97% of them are found, and a big chunk of them are literally kidnapped in custody agreements. Like, the overwhelming majority of them are parents or immediate relatives. The number of kids that actually get abducted by strangers that they don't know in, like, minivans and the way that QAnon portrays it is...
Well, you can order them in pizza boxes.
It's insanely small. But, yeah, if you ask them, they're fucking, you know, getting... They're ordering kids in pizza boxes, but they poke holes in it or something.
So they can breathe or something.
Yeah, I mean, it makes sense.
So the kid doesn't expire.
Hey, yeah, you too.
So the kid doesn't expire when being delivered. I mean, dude. This is...
Yo, I fuck heavy with this mask shit. Mask, beanie, nobody fucking knows who I am.
Yeah.
Except for, like, a couple fans, but... This was awesome. I'm gonna keep doing this.
By the way, stream snipers, that was good stream sniping.
Yeah.
You didn't disrupt, you didn't give us up. Just came and said what's up. Good
job.
We
walked for a minute, dude.
We walked so far, bro.
Yeah. Imperialist Watch, nobody would know you anyway, Omega Lol. Fucking got him, dude. Especially in a hyper-political crowd like that of Republicans and, like, QAnon people, that is, like, definitely a group of individuals that I do not want to even risk being outed on.
Yeah.
And, like, with like, all gas, no brakes, they know who they are, right? So they were yelling Antifa media. Like, that's what they fucking do. They out you. They out you and they say, like, you're Antifa media. But they couldn't. You know why they couldn't? Because I was spitting fucking bars of truth at them.
Mm-hmm.
Not fat, kernels.
Fat truth nuts.
Yeah, not kernels, just fucking whole loads, my guy. Spitting rope. Spreading rope, not hope.
That was pretty good shit.
Real Antifa is right here. Boys in the blue.
Bike bros.
Biker bros. Protecting and serving. Kinda hard to kill black children when you're on a bike.
Imagine being the guy who rides a bike when all your coworkers have tanks.
Yeah. Biker bros, too hard to shoot when both of your hands are busy.
On the wheel.
Biker bros. Why are they all over here?
I think they're coming this way.
It's true. What's going on, guys?
How you guys doing?
Doing well.
Can we cross? Are we allowed to cross?
Yep.
Right. I don't want to get a jaywalking ticket.
One of you is like, that was a trap. We got him.
We got him. Arrest him.
Should have known better than listen to me.
Those are electric bikes. I didn't know that.
Really?
Yeah.
Wait, the cops?
Yeah.
They have electric bikes on?
You see the battery packs on the...
No. That's like... I want to ask them how it feels to be the only in-shape police unit in in America. Like, literally every other cop brigade is just porky and portly.
Damn, we walked so far.
Yeah, dude. This is great, great fucking cardio. I didn't even think about it because I was just in the zone, dude. You were in the zone, too. You fucking killed it. Thank you, Will.
Thank you.
You were awesome. Everybody, twitch.tv/WillNeff, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right. If you liked the amuse-bouche of what happened today, you're going to get a whole dinner of truth when you come to my channel, baby.
You stop talking French like that. I'm going to think I'm gonna think you want to do some.
I'm taking it back.
Some gay stuff. It's gonna get me off.
Hey now, I mean.
What are you doing? You're doing Pedalwood stuff right here. With the French shit.
Listen.
The most embarrassing part about it is that, like, someone legitimately recognizing me from afar and then thinking I'm in support of. Oh my god, old lady. You're gonna die. Why are you maskless and advocating for masklessness?
Dude, the funniest part of the whole day was when that one woman was just screaming at people.
Oh, the brunch here? Yeah, the black people at brunch.
You gotta wake up!
Yeah, about being black.
Put down your Grand Slam breakfast and open up your eyes.
It was fucking great. It was fucking top down through and through.
Oh, yeah.
Every part of that was a jamboree.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, this is good because this is our first time doing something like this, seriously. I think we can do this a lot more frequently.
Oh, yeah.